This is the acceleration due to gravity at above the surface of the earth. Acceleration due to gravity above the surface of the earth, where h is very smaller than the radius of the earth. Here, as the height increases, the acceleration due to gravity decreases. Now, here, capital M mass of an earth, and above the surface of the earth, small m mass of an object we are taking at a height h. Then the distance between these two is r plus h. By this gravitational force, gmm by r plus h whole square, equation 1. Weight of an object is f is equal to mg, then g is equal to, we will get gm by r plus h whole square. But g is equal to gm by r square, we can write gm is equal to g into r square. And substituting this, we will get gh is equal to g by 1 plus h by r whole square. By the binomial expansion theorem, we can write 1 plus h by r whole power minus 2 as 1 minus 2h by r. That is, gh is equal to g into 1 minus 2h by r. Here, as the height increases, then the g value decreases. Now, how this acceleration due to gravity is changing below the surface of the earth. Now, below the surface of the earth, g value below the surface of the earth, that is gd. How it is changing? Here, I am taking, this is the capital M mass of an earth, and this is the center, and this is the radius of the earth. Now, I am considering small m mass of an object is on the surface of the earth. The small m mass of an object is on the earth surface. Now, the acceleration due to gravity, that is the acceleration due to gravity, g is equal to gm by r square. This is the acceleration due to gravity on the surface of the earth, that is g is equal to gm by r square. Now, this earth is in the form of sphere, is in the spherical shape. Now, mass of an earth, this mass of the earth we can write as volume of the earth into density. Here I am taking the density of the earth is rho and the volume is 4 by 3 pi r cube. Now the mass of an earth m is equal to 4 by 3 pi r cube into density rho. On substituting this value into this equation, we will get g is equal to gm. In the place of m, I am writing 4 by 3 pi r cube into rho by r square. Here r square, here r cube. Then we will get 4 by 3 pi r into g into rho. This is the acceleration due to gravity on the surface of the earth when we consider the density of the earth. Then here, if we go below the depth of the surface, surface of the earth, then this is the depth d. At this depth d and the distance from this object to radius, that is r minus d. Here, now considering this m mass of an object is below the depth of the surface, that is at depth d, that is the distance from this center to the object is r minus d. Now, at this distance r minus d, the acceleration due to gravity gd is equal to, that is 4 by 3 pi r minus d into g into rho. Now, this is equation 1, this is equation 2. Now, by doing equation 1 by 2, equation 2 by equation 1 will give the g d by g is equal to 4 by 3 pi into r minus rho into r minus d into g into rho by 4 by 3 pi r into g into rho. Now these are all cancel, we'll get g d by g is equal to r minus d by r we will get. That is, by this we'll get g d by g is equal to 1 minus d by r. That is, g d is equal to g into 1 minus d by r. This is the acceleration due to gravity at the depth d below the surface of the earth. That is, gd is equal to g into 1 minus d by r. Here, on the surface of the earth, m mass of an object, then the acceleration due to gravity g is equal to gm by r square. By considering the density of an earth, that is rho, then the mass of earth is equal to volume into density, that is 4 by 3 pi r cube into rho. Now, if the object, m mass of an object is coming below the surface of the earth, then the distance is r minus d. At this distance r minus d, the acceleration due to gravity gd is equal to 4 by 3 pi into r minus d into g into rho. Then by doing this 2 by 1, then we'll get gd is equal to g into 1 minus d by r. As the depth increases below the surface of the earth, then the gd value, the acceleration due to gravity, also decreases.